Hi friends, today I discuss factorization of polynomial of degree 2 and 3. There are two methods of factorization of polynomial of this type of higher degree 2 and 3. The first method is splitting the middle term. The first method is splitting the middle term, and basically it is used of quadratic polynomial. So this method is used for quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial, which of the general form ax square plus bx plus c. Now take an example, 6x square plus 7x plus 5. How to solve this quadratic polynomial or factorize this polynomial by splitting the middle term method? Now we take middle term coefficient 17x or middle term 17x. And the last term and the first term. This is the first term, this is the second term, this is the third term. 17x. Now we can find two numbers. The sum of those two numbers is 17x or p plus q equal to 17. If we take some numbers, first number is 15x and other number is 2x. And multiplication of these two numbers is equal to the multiplication of first term coefficient and last term. Those two numbers are selected which can add it or subtract it to get middle term, and by multiplying get equal to the multiplication of first term coefficient and last term. If you see this number, 15 into 2, which is also equal to 30. So my selection is right, 15 and 2. Now in quadratic polynomial, 6x square plus 2x plus 15x plus 5. Again solve this, 6x square plus 2x plus 15x plus 5. 6x square plus 2x plus 15x plus 5. Now we take 2x as a common in first bracket, so we can remain 3x plus 1 plus, now we take common 5, so remain 3x plus 1. If you want to check my solution is right or not, then check this step or cross-check this step. If the value of bracket in value in first bracket and value in second bracket is equal, then your solution is right till there. Then again common 3x plus 1 in one bracket and 2x plus 5 in bracket. These two are the factors of the polynomial 6x square plus 17x plus 5. I hope you understand this method splitting the middle term. You choose to find two numbers which can be added or subtracted to get the middle term, which is in this question 17x, and by multiplying given two to give result to the result as same as the multiplication of first term coefficient and last term. This is your answer. Now continue to the second method, factor theorem. Let's take an example. Factorize y square minus 5y plus 6 by factor theorem. Let's suppose or assume polynomial p in the variable y, py equal to y square minus 5y plus 6. Now first method, first step of this theorem or this process, polynomial py, it's take to y minus a and y minus b. Then we take, if you know that or you know that the constant term in this multiplication, constant term in this multiplication is AB, which is equal in polynomial if you equate AB with polynomial py, then we know that AB equal to 6. So to look for the factors of py, we look at the factor of 6. If you know that the factors of 6 is 1, 2 and 3. You can easily find by divisional method. Now we check P2. Now we check or putting the value one by one in our polynomial. Firstly put p equal to p2, so 2 square minus 5 into 2 plus 6 equal to, this is 4, this is minus 10 plus 6, which is equal to 0, so that y minus 2 is a factor of py. Now again we check, P3 is 3 square minus 5 into 3 plus 6. This is 9 minus 15 plus 6, which is also equal to 0. So that y minus 3 is also a factor of py. So we get two factors of this polynomial, and this polynomial is quadratic or degree of 2, so we can only get two polynomials. So therefore this polynomial is represented as y square minus 5y plus 6 equal to y minus 2 and y minus 3. This is your answer. This is the second method to factorize any quadratic polynomial, which is called factor theorem. I hope you understand this method. So I hope you understand this video, and please download the Scholar Learning app. And if you already downloaded this, then enjoy the video.